Let's take this question now. This question came in CAT 2019 in the second slot, I guess. And it says, again, you have a passage given to you and you have four choices. Now, this is a slightly difficult question because the options are really very close and the chances are very high that you may not get this question correct. So you always have this choice of leaving the question in case you feel that, or you can take just, let's say, calculated guess and hoping that it turns out to be true eventually. But this kind of guess should be taken only when you have attempted a good number of questions and you're confident that you have got many of them correct, or that you will get many of them correct. Let's read this now. Language is an autapomorphy found only in our lineage and not shared with other branches of our group, such as primates. So language is basically not shared with our other branches of our groups, right? We also have no definitive evidence that any species other than Homo sapiens ever had language. This is also very clear. The author has said that we don't have any evidence. However, it must be noted straight away that language is not a monolithic entity, but rather a complex bundle of traits that must have evolved over a significant time frame. So language is unique to us. It must have evolved over a significant time frame. Moreover, language crucially draws on aspects of cognition that are long established in the primate lineage, such as memory. The language faculty as a whole comprises more than just the uniquely linguistic features. There is more to it than this uniquely linguistic feature, such as what? Memory. So first of all, language is unique to the branch group of primates, right? And secondly, it is not a monolithic thing. It has evolved. So that is the first. So primates is the first thing. Evolution of language, second thing. And it draws on many aspects, such as memory. So that is the third thing. So these 1, 2, 3 things are very important, right? Let's look at the first option. It says language, a derived trait found on. So who says it's a derived trait? The moment you see a word which is slightly unfamiliar, language is unique to us. It has evolved. Everything is given to us. But a derived trait is not given. And that's the reason why I would definitely give it a negative. Right? And fourth, second says language evolved with linguistic features, building on features of cognition as memory. Evolved, very good. And building on cognition on features such as memory. Why? Because it says the language faculty as a whole comprises more than just uniquely linguistic features. It builds on lots of things such as memory. So two looks very good. Unless something better comes, I would always mark two as the right choice. Three says language is not a single uniform entity, but the end result of a long. Now the problem is, people, that option 3 and option 2 are very close. There's not much to choose from. But option 2 has two very important points: that it has evolved and it builds on features like memory, whereas option 3 has only one thing, and that is language is not a single uniform entity but a result of linguistic evolution. So the completeness in 2 is greater than the completeness in 3. Some of you might say even 2 is missing the idea of that language is unique to us. But in that case, option 3 is missing two ideas: that language is unique to us, and secondly, language shares cognitive features such as memory. Whereas option 2 is missing only your own idea. So if at all I have to pick between 2 and 3, I would pick 2. Why? Because at least it gives me two very important points. The first point is that language evolved with linguistic features and it's built on cognition such as memory. Whereas 3 says language is not a single uniform entity but end of a result of long. That's it. Only partial facts have come in 3. Two good things have come in 2. So 2 wins over 3. Language is a distinctively human feature. There is no evidence. So again, option 4 picks only on 1. So option 4 gives me only one idea from the passage. Option 3 gives me only one idea from the passage. Option 2 gives me two ideas from the passage, whereas the passage has 3 ideas. So you might wonder that all of them are incomplete, but 4 and 3 are more incomplete than 2. And therefore 2 is the best summary and the right answer.